Hello, everyone. Welcome to some Quantum Moves. So this is a game that is actually, well, it says right here, it's featured in Nature, the prestigious science journal. It's one of those prestigious journals in the world for science, just in general. And this is an educational game, but it's not educational in the sense that you will learn something. It's educational in the sense that this is a puzzle game. So as you solve puzzles, you give data to a research team for quantum computers, which is why it's called Quantum Move. So this is trying to help figure out how humans solve problems and then in turn use that information to help design quantum computers in the future. So I thought this was a really cool game. I wanted to show this off, one-off episode. There's not going to be any more episodes of this, and this will be a short episode. But I wanted to show this off to you guys because I think this is really cool as a science thing and really cool as like a game concept. So basically what just happened, though, let me just go ahead and play it again for you guys. So it says awaiting data up here. It's collecting all the data that you do. This is the fidelity, so how much you're keeping, and then your time limit. This purple stuff, you need to get inside this box as much of it as you possibly can without having it spill over onto the flat area above. You pull down, and it comes down with you, right? You push up, and it goes up with you, and if you go up too far, now you see it just kind of goes everywhere. It's all over the place, and you can't get it all back. So you have, like, you know, 10% fidelity. Like, it's pretty bad. Like, you don't want to do that. So the goal is to get as much of this stuff into the main box there as best as you can. That's the main goal there. Now, there's tons and tons of... Well, not tons. There's plenty of levels. And then you can explain all the science of it if you want to look more into that. There's the whole explanation of the science behind this game and what they're researching and all of that. And because of this is obviously a video without any ads. If you guys are not running ad blocker, you notice this video has no ads, no monetization. Because this is all purely educational and I fully support it. So all of this is in here. And if you want to pause and go frame by frame here, you can, by all means. But their website, scienceathome.org, is where you can get all the information. They do save the... Hang on. Go home. They do save all the information, like the... Your score, basically, and like maximum is 999999, so six nines. They save all that, and there's a high score list, and you can check on all that as well. There are some people who are really, like, they're pushing to get the absolute high score. And it's impressive, kind of the scores that they're getting. But this game is a great example of the gamification of science. And gamification of education. So, anyways, if you guys want to help science and play a short puzzle game, by all means, this would be a great way to do that. All the credits right here, Science at Home team. But anyways, I just thought I would just let you guys know. Apparently we have one star. Oh, that's the Bring Home Water. That's the one that's super famous. That's hard. That one is a hard one. But anyways, you guys want to check it out, there will be a download link in the description down below, straight at Science at Home, which I believe is what it was called. And again, it's if you want to support science, if you want to support quantum computing and quantum computers and get a free puzzle game out of it that you can sit down and play, this is for you. It's a fun little puzzle game. So anyways, I thought I'd just go and let you guys know. Hope you guys appreciate it, and I will see you guys with another video in the future. So thank you for watching. I appreciate it. And DFTBA.